Yeah, welcome. My name is Janis Hagener, and we present some work on personalized aortic valve prosthesis here. So we want to personalize aortic valve prosthesis, actually, and this mainly says that we want to estimate the optimal shape of the three leaflets that form this valve. To be honest, we already solved the issue because the biggest problem is that 3D imaging of the aortic valve structure is not really possible. But we presented an approach already to estimate these leaflet shapes from some surrounding tissue information. So we presented this, and people came to us and said, yeah, well, this is nice, but this is not realistic because it's too expensive, you have big logistic issues, and you will never get regulation for this. So we said, yeah, well, you're right. So we came up with a new approach and said, well, is there something in between one size fits all, as it is now, and full personalization, where we have really tailored prosthesis for each and every patient. And actually, the thing in between that we try to tackle and what we present here is identifying typical shapes of aortic valves so that we can say these are five different prosthesis shapes that we can offer. And this basically leads us to a clustering approach. We want to do clustering, but we can't do this directly in the image space. And this is why we came up with a pipeline that we present here. At first, we needed a data set. As I said, imaging is not really good possible, so we did some workaround where we cut out these leaflets from porcine aortic valves. And then we trained an autoencoder to find a good representation of our aortic valve. And in this representation, when we already trained our autoencoder, we can perform clustering in a sensible way because we have good features. And from these cluster centers, the cool thing is that we can evaluate the prosthesis because we can generate images of this prosthesis, of this shape, using the decoder network. The whole pipeline looks like this. Don't want to get into detail, but we can encode all the three leaflets that form one valve. So we concatenate this to have the valve representation here, and then we can cluster, and we can generate the prosthesis here. I don't want to get into details about the results. We can discuss this at the poster. The cool thing is we can do analysis on how many clusters we need, so how many prostheses should be there present in the wild. The main thing is that we present an end-to-end method for unsupervised prosthesis shape identification directly on images. And this is not only limited to aortic valve prosthesis, but to basically each kind of shape that we can image in the body. Yeah, thanks. Would be happy to see you at the poster.